know, you don't get too caught up on a perfect room, because I don't think I've ever done a room where it's been perfect. There's always been a problem. It's either too big, it's either too small, it's the wrong shape, it's too square. You know, it's very rare that you can create a room from scratch and say, this is a perfect cinema. Conversation.
Oh, so I'm not looking at the camera.
Yeah, if you want to. Don't have to. The room itself, it was never meant to be a cinema. It was, what were they?
This was the original storeroom.
When did they decide to turn it into a cinema?
I think they realised when they did the excavation they had enough room in the basement to put everything there and make this the cinema.
It's a brand new build, right? The whole house.
Yeah, the house is brand new, yeah. They've got a hallway next to us, and then there's the bar and the gym behind us.
They were open to the idea of a separate space.
Yeah, that's right. There was no real spec or anything they were trying to achieve.
The room is 3 meters wide. It's almost 6 meters long.
Yeah.
Is it the perfect room dimensions for a cinema? Maybe not.
Yeah, so by the time we decided to make this room a cinema, it was built.
Yeah.
So we couldn't change it.
No, so we had to work within that space. Yeah. Right. Were there any challenges that you thought was wrong with the space?
My concern was that because it's so narrow, we couldn't get a decent-sized screen.
Okay.
So, I mean, the screen we've got is almost wall-to-wall. I think that's 120-inch, 16.9. Okay. Yeah. And having, I mean, we've just got 5 chairs in here.
5 chairs works well.
Yeah, 5 chairs and a couple of beanbags, so they can fit everyone.
Yeah. And you've got that nice length. So, the steps are great. The razor that we've done is 300 high.
Yeah.
With a 150 step.
That's it, yeah.
The system that we ended up working with was the MX-10 system.
I definitely wanted something behind the screen.
Yeah.
Just because of space again. Yeah, so it's basically custom joinery to hold the MX-10.
Yep.
So yeah, enough depth for that, plus a little bit more below for all the AV equipment.
Yep. And the height of the room was good. It was a standard 2.7 high. How high was it?
Yeah, so the star ceiling is basically 50 mil off the slab.
Yep.
And then they've got the bulkhead around, so we could fit the Atmos speakers.
Atmos effect speakers in a perfect world would have been in a little bit using the Atmospherix in the A20s.
Well, that angle achieves what we wanted anyway.
Absolutely. Yeah. The sweet spot is kind of between the two chairs, but you get a really nice experience in both levels. The star ceiling was always going to be used because that was an afterthought as well, wasn't it?
The star ceiling, well, we provisioned for it as far as cabling, but during the rough-in stage, I spoke to the client about we definitely need some treatment.
Yeah.
So I thought, treat the ceiling, and like you said, treat the walls. So the star ceiling was probably the most, because it does two things, looks nice and it has a bit of treatment.
Yeah. Did we always plan on the symmetrics? I thought we initially planned on...
They were going to be bigger in walls, but we didn't have the depth.
Right, okay, so that's what went with the... Okay. How do you think the room worked out?
No, I think it's spectacular.
Yeah. So you've got the experience is watching a movie.
That's right.
Everything else that happens in a room, I refer to as the drama of a room. The drama of the room is the star ceilings, the automation, the lighting, the posters, And there's likely to be something on the back wall still, which we haven't done yet.
Yeah, right? So whether it's another poster or just dedicated acoustic treatments.
Yeah, everything pretty much in here was bespoke made. The chairs were all custom made.
Yeah, the chairs were custom. The star ceiling was custom. The posters were made to order.
Right, so you can actually build a room and then see the improvement.
Yeah.
As you add in those layers, how it actually helps the sound.
That's right. And because we added, first it was the carpet, obviously, then the posters, then the star ceiling, then the chairs. And every time we did something, there was a noticeable difference in reverb and just the echo in the room.
Which is great. So, we've done a calibration now, and the calibration has also helped because it's acued some of the problems, and we can still get some better clarity by maybe adding a bit more acoustic trimming, which we will. I mean, the only thing we might want to look at, if we can, is maybe something where the first reflection point is from those speakers. So, tell me about the control system that we've
used. So, we've got Crestron Home running through the whole house,
controlling
everything from the pool, the air conditioning, all the access control, the alarm, Video distribution, lighting, obviously, the blinds,
mm-hmm.
basically it does everything. And we've added NVX to distribute Foxtel in every room, and we're using the touchscreen remotes in here to control everything.
Which are these things here.
That's it.
Yeah, which work really well. And these are great because you've got a mixture of textile operation, and also you've got the touch operation,
yeah.
and you've got the touch panel on the wall, which operates everything as well. It adds the luxury to the to the room.
In terms
of the equipment in this room, we've used the Anthem 1120.
Yeah.
We've got a Blu-ray player, which I think is an LG Blu-ray player, Apple TV. So most of what they're watching is going to be through streaming media, Netflix, Disney Plus.
There is a Blu-ray player that I put in as part of the job, but I don't think they've used it, if I'm honest.
Yeah, and there's a couple of game consoles as well.
Or and with the Yamaha console. PX3.
Yeah, the PX3 is going to be the sub amp driving those subs. But we are using bass management from the Anthem.
Yeah.
And then allowing some limiters to be affected with
just the for protection.
PX3, the sub, yeah, protect everything. What I like about the room is a really good feel. You've got really good consistency of vocals from back to front row now. So when you're watching something, whether you're sitting on the back or sitting on the front, there is not that much of a difference. The EQ has really helped with that. And the feel of the low frequency, the basses work really, really well. You're feeling it up through the lounges and you're feeling it in your body, but it's not droney, it's not overpowering, and the bass isn't affecting the clarity of vocals, which is really important.
Yeah, that's right.
Is there anything about the room that you would change, if you could change it?
Little things like positioning of the door. I think it's a bit of an awkward spot.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, the air conditioning probably is a bit noisy. When we have it on in a quiet movie, you actually did, we'll just say it was about 50 dB.
Yeah, about 50 dB that up to,
That was on medium speed. A bit of width, more width might have been nicer, make the room a little bit more square, maybe a bigger screen, but again, 120-inch screen in here, and most of the time the kids are almost in front of it playing Xbox anyway.
You know, the funny thing is that when you're watching a movie and you're in the movie, because the sound is so good and the sound is so broad and so wide, the screen size, you kind of don't think,
yeah,
oh, I wish I had a bigger screen.
It kind of works really well.
It was a great project to work on, not overly complicated.
Yep.
They had to make some compromises, but those compromises don't really affect the end experience, which is enjoying watching a movie.
No, nothing is really detracted from. There's nothing that, you know, I wish, oh, you know, it's a shame we haven't been able to do this or that.
Yeah.
I think it's going to be enjoyable. Well, the cinemas, they've had this room for maybe 6 weeks and there's already 500 hours on the projector.
Oh, good. Oh, that's great. It's great when they use it. Yeah. So to have a room that's kind of almost finished now, and you go back and we look at the designs, and it's pretty much what we created. It's what's happened.
Yeah,
it's all sort of gone in from step to step.
Yeah.
And it's worked out really, really well. So this is
and being involved from the beginning. I mean, we've done cinemas where we're let down by the reverberation in the structure and things like that. Yeah. But been able to stick my head in every process and add insulation or seal things where I've had to, I think it's made a bit of difference.
The earlier designers can get involved in a project, then the less chance of those annoying little problems creeping up and ruining things for us. So thank you very much for this conversation.
Thank you.
How good was that? Well, you were natural.
Wow.
We could do this for a
I thought you were going to be standing behind there and asking me questions.
Well, you don't want me in the picture? You want all the credit.
When you said interview,
I thought it was going to be like... Well, this is an interview. It's like Oprah. Oprah sits across the...
We should be a host. Oh, we've got the same shirts on, so we're basically related.
Oh, yeah. That worked out well.
That's it.
Yeah, that's good. Not too shabby.
Let's do more.
Yeah, I'm sure I can get the audio. I'm doing it.